Oil paints have a quality and flexibility of handling, which when well used cannot be rivaled by any other medium. Choose a few set of hog hair and sable hair brush for your work in oil paint. I am more comfortable with the hard bristles of hog hair for this portrait. I will start by painting this particular model in two different styles, using oil paints both the time. I choose a more realistic approach to painting his portrait. But remember, I do not mean to paint a photograph of the model. I will remain close to interpreting his character as I see it, and not just the way it is. Before you begin to start painting a portrait of a model who is posing in a studio, design the light arrangement of the setup. In this case, the source of light is placed on the left, making the right profile of his face appear darker than the left. The most widely used painting surface or support for oil paint is canvas. Stretch and prime your canvas with a suitable ground before you start work. I will draw the basic sketch of the model directly using burnt sienna on canvas. Some students may pick a pencil to mark important features and draw basic forms before applying color. Since I have a lot of experience, I can take the route of direct color application. You all must eventually be able to do this. Pose the basic patch of the eye and nose. I pick green to draw the outline. There are many ways to paint in oil. Each artist develops his method over the years. But the fundamental to any personally evolved style are two basic styles, Ala Prema and the traditional method. Completing a painting in one session in full color with opaque paint so that any previous drawing or underpainting tends to have little effect on the subsequent layer is called Ala Prema. That is the method I will apply to this portrait. I keep the basic form in mind. Half close your eyes to see the model as a blob of grays and whites, and check the basic form of his face, head and hair. This way you will mostly get a correct drawing of your model. At this point, check the main shadows and highlights too. What is the nature of light and dark on your subject? The broadly mark these areas on his face. Compose your drawing, whether you want to draw the model till the torso or you only wish to capture the shoulders is a creative decision. You may draw the model's clothes till his chest. It entirely depends on the size of your paper and if there is an interesting element that you see and feel will add to the character of your subject. I will develop the rest of the facial features and slowly draw the contours of the face. I usually begin by drawing the eyes and then moving out to draw the basic shape of the face. That is my method, and you may feel comfortable drawing portraits in some other way. You will invent your personal techniques by continuous practice. I will start adding the first layer of shadow of darker middle tones under this chin, lips, and the right profile of his face. Develop the hair using strokes that resemble the direction of the flow of hair on your model's head. The two strands of hair strutting out of the head on the left are interesting character traits. You must also remember the angle of your model, as the model may tend to shift a few times due to tiredness. In that case, it is a good idea for you to know the exact position that the model started posing in. To make things simpler, you may draw a mark on the wall to set the model's gaze. I drew the basic sketch and shadows for the portrait using burnt sienna and sap green. I will fill the white areas, suggesting the highlights, and lighter middle tones with a light warm shade like yellow ochre mixed with a small amount of chromium. If you look at the model carefully, you will see a tint of red in the dark skin tone. I will add the red to the existing ochre and use this color for the dark middle tone areas. The part of the face where beard grows mostly has a shade of green. If you half close your eyes and see these shades, you will be able to spot them quite easily. Shade of pink, reds, yellows, orange and greens are some of the most commonly found colors in the skin tone. I will use the green over the face and some on the neck. I will develop the ear now. Starting with the contour or outline of the ear. Be confident while applying single strokes like I will make for the ear. Shade the darker middle tones and shadows. Observe the basic form and the strongest visible line to draw the ear correctly. The hollow of the ear has a lot of tonal variation due to the way lines turn and curve to form this facial feature. Let me move on the work on the clothes, starting with the collar. If you visualize the portrait in black and white, it will help you know if you are applying the colors correctly to create contrast. And whether the application of colors are achieving the depth of that the portrait needs in order to look like a three-dimensional drawing. To see your work in values of black to white, half close your eyes to eliminate the details and see the drawing as blobs of color. You should see a variation of tones and notice the positive, negative, and linear areas quite clearly. Painting the shirt and cardigan of the model in real colors. If the clothes have a texture or print, as is the case in this portrait, then see how by using a few lines can you express the texture or print rather drawing those elements in detail. I fill blue for the shirt only after I made an outline of a shirt and collar. He is wearing a grey cardigan, and the decision to add his sleeveless cardigan I thought will make for a better composition. It is a good idea to paint the deepest shadows and strongest highlights at the end. For practical purpose, it is best to start with the mid-range of tones so that you can gauge more accurately the intensity of the lights and darks. Make sure you visually measure the width of the model's shoulder. Drawing the shoulder width too wide or small will create an overall imbalance in proportions of head to body. Add just enough details to the clothes to prevent it from distracting from the center of interest, which is the face in any portrait study. After I estimate the width of the shoulder visually, I apply a broad line to mark the contour of his arm and only then fill it with paint. You may fill colors or move towards the edge of the form too, if that is your preferred route. as the light falls from the left side. The left collar of the shirt will also be lighter than the right. For that, I am painting a light shade of gray. Just a few strokes to mark the light on the collar. I will paint the right arm, extending it downwards, before I return to develop the left shoulder and the cardigan on the same side. I am moving my brush, creating strokes that will help show the texture of the cardigan. Adding a shadow below the collar is very important. It will lift the collar, creating depth. Step of adding a line of highlight on the outline and the tip of the collar will further lift it above the shirt. Observe carefully how I am painting light and shade to develop the folds on the cloth. By using the dry red brush, I am softening and merging the tones for a smooth look of the cloth. There are general guidelines to paint in any medium, but to master and develop your own method, you will have to experience the material through a lot of practice. I am adding lighter strokes for highlights on the left side. Just a strong few strokes are enough. There is a texture on the edge of the sweater. Draw the texture, I follow the direction of the lines and not the details. The woven details of the wool is not what I will draw. I rather capture the essence of the texture and interpret it my way. You may half close your eyes to see the direction that the lines move in. Which are the most lines you see that define the texture or design of the cloth most? Painting the background in an oil painting is an essential step. Since the surface of the oil painting is always a stark white canvas, the white can stand out and create a lot of noise disturbing the main subject. The white can distract you from the focus point. Another reason is that the sharp white makes the portrait appear flat. It finishes the dimensions. The background must appear as a part of your main subject rather than standing out separately. Which is the reason that I am painting it with this dark shade, which goes well with the color scheme of the entire portrait. Now the background appears like a wall. As I apply a very light value of the same brownish burnt sienna color here, now the portrait will stand out further. The foreground and the background are in tussle. They play with each other. The contrast that the light cream brown creates makes the portrait vibrant. It is the same fundamental of applying warm and cool colors that is used here. I have used green, yellow ochre and burnt sienna to achieve this light shade. Where burnt sienna is the base and the other two colors are to create a lighter value. It is a warm and lively colors scheme. It is up to an artist and a personal decision of which scheme you choose to paint the portrait in. Half close your eyes again to see the variation of tones that the background has. Take a black and white picture of your work and you will understand this point further. I am adding another darker shade just below the highlight to take the focus on the eyes. Add cheekbones. Darkening the shades on the right profile of the face. Below the lower lip, this model has a protruding set of teeth, which makes his mouth stand out more. A painting medium is used to make the paint easier to apply and also to thin down its consistency. Usually an equal mix of linseed oil and turpentine are used as a medium by most artists. But it does have a disadvantage of slow drying. Mediums that contains varnish, beeswax or stand oil overcome this problem and help the paint from dripping when heavily thinned. Many ready-made mediums are available in the market. When choosing a medium, consider the finish required. The finish required. For a shiny finish, use a varnish, and for matte finish, one that contains beeswax. Color is a very personal matter, but to begin, think of a color scheme in mind. While oil paints come in a range of colors, a limited palette helps in a clear thought process. The colors mostly used for this portrait were burnside, orange, chrome yellow, sap green, yellow ochre, and shades of red. This is a warm color scheme. It will evoke reliability and trust in a person's mind. This face has a strong bone structure. If he moves the shape of his jawline, the face changes completely. As the form takes sharp cuts several times along the jawline, so it becomes very important for me to remember the angle of the model and correct him each time he moves. I worked on the light and shade of the nose to bring out the bumpy bone and the roundness of the tip of his nose. Thank you. I will add highlights over the eyebrows. A light highlights in the center of his lips. And a similar tone for the highlight on the tip of his left ear. I am defining the form of his hair by adding middle shadows on the top layer of his hair. The bone structure is also responsible for the way light and shadow form on the face. Since this model has a strong, harsh bone structure, there are some crucial lines that have formed over the age. And those now work as character line, for example, the one from the nose to the corner of the mouth. You can paint as many details as you would like after this point, but I am always aware of the basic fundamental of negative, positive and linear space when drawing or painting anything This technique is particularly useful in very direct and immediate forms like the spoon. In this portrait, I keep a positive area as the left eye and the left cheekbone. It is this area you notice first when you look at this portrait. I think the white in the left eye is too sharp. So, without finishing that completely, I will tone it down. Painting wet on wet is the technique of applying the color on the top to another that is still wet so that the colors blend or run into each other. Very carefully, I will add a delicate thin stroke on the lower lip. The tip of the chin for the highlight. I will do the same for the bone of the nose, just between the eyebrow center. The right side of the face is not completely dark. Light falls on that part too, so you will find some areas lighter than the rest. You may consider these areas as highlights for the right profile. These areas are the right cheekbone and the part just above the mouth. Apart from the wrinkle, we saw starting from the side of the nostril to the corner of the mouth on the left side. You will notice a similar wrinkle from the inner corner of the right eye to the cheekbone. I mark it with a warm shade of red. I paint the area over his mouth with a lighter shade for it to stand out as he has a raised denture. Thank you. We are close to completing our portrait. The strokes that I am now applying are likely final touches. Deeper shadows, like the line below his eye, starting from the inner corner of the right eye, the lips, the skin tone of the lips is also dark in the first place. I had to work on the skin tone and shade the light and dark on the mouth accordingly. The lightest highlights or the darkest shadows must look a part of the portrait. They must stand out, but that does not allow them to make noise and disturb the drawing overall. So you will see, I bring them down by a shade or soften the edges for the better result. The glint in the eye that I have been talking about all the lessons is the most significant detail in a portrait. It brings the portrait to life and allows the eye to appear like they are actually looking at something. It also decides the direction in which the model is looking at. I use a nib of drawing pen to add these white dots. Other than this, for the final touches, I soften the edges of certain very strong strokes. The highlights and shadows too. Check your portrait for any unfinished stroke or an area that requires some detail. Thank you. like a few strands of hair behind the left ear strands out in this case. I am now ready to remove the masking tape that was defining my area of work on the large canvas. After I remove the tape, the clean white lines that forms outline around the drawing also works as a frame and let me give the portrait better.